Hello and welcome to my episode of Life at Nash. What episode are we on now, Mikey? Six?
Six.
Six, episode six. As if it's taken six episodes to get me in front of camera. I'm not going to cop out like the other boys and just use it as a fishing session. So we've taken it as an insight into a typical day on a shoot. We've been windy, innit? Got Oliver here.
Hi, Oliver.
Hello.
Dave, you're on camera. Looks all nervous and that. We're doing a 24 episode. We've got another series releasing in a few weeks. Most of them are shot. We've just got the most elusive man at Nash Tackle to film, Tom Foreman. So that's nice. It's like memory lane, me and Tommy together again. But yeah, he's around there. We've just finished loading the stuff up to go and shoot him. So we're gonna go get the camera set up and get it underway. Let's do it. Nice little lake, mate. Ain't been empty in it.
Don't tell him that.
Bought the cameras.
Yeah,
it's like.
Oh, that's what it is.
It's inception. I'm filming you, he's filming me. Who are you filming? Jealous? I was always the brains behind it anyway, wasn't I?
What?
Life at Nash. Really, it was always my show. You were just my puppet.
Nah, you were just my skibby.
Everyone thought you were the funny one.
Trying to get a bite early, isn't it?
Early, yeah. Early doors.
Early.
And so should you be.
I am. Gonna
eyes on the water, yeah? Right, we're going to get some cameras ready and then we'll crack on.
Just need to see one.
Oh, yeah. I never go filming without my Leatherman Surge. Maybe one day they'll sponsor me. Careful, she's also classed as a deadly weapon in the right hands.
Thanks very much.
You're welcome.
How about I just put two little tester rods up for a bit and then we do the intro.
Right, Tommy used to be such like a good guy to film because it was always by the book, whatever you need me to do, I'll do it and we'll catch as well. And now look at him.
That's cute.
I like this real quick off the barrier, impulsive angling. Bam, on him, bam, on him.
Shut up.
You know, you've only got 24 hours, yeah. Tommy's been going for a couple of hours now, so there's been a little bit of break in the filming. He's actually just gone for a walk to see if he can spot something up there, so I'm just keeping an eye on his rods for him. So, while it's gone a bit of downtime here, I'm gonna let you see. It's actually quite similar. We've got another section, which is Mikey went along and did a bit of behind the scenes with Finn and Mike Tobin. Finley's got a series himself called Day Ticket Diaries. The concept is he goes to as many different day tickets around the country as he can to fish them and just make a video about how he approaches them. Our aim being that, you know, in a few years, you'll be able to go on YouTube and just type in any day ticket that you can think of and Finn will have been there and you will be able to see how he got on and the tactics he used. This one's from when he went to Twynersh fishery. I think it was back in the summer actually. Mikey went along, as I say, and yeah, this is how he got on.
Instagram content, big mirror in the margin.
Big mirror in the margin.
Big mirror in the margin.
Where are we, Finn?
We are at, I can't pronounce it correctly, Twynersh fishery.
That's a mouthful for him, innit? Twynersh fishery. Twynersh fishery. I've seen the comments on the videos. Do people even know what he's saying?
Hit seven, doing dirt ticket diaries. Done one night so far, caught two, lost one. But if you've watched the film, we're not including what we lost one behind the scenes there. And yeah, the weather is horrendous. Cold, windy, raining.
I've brought the weather down with me, haven't I?
Yeah, it came from up north, but two northerners and a southerner. The southerner is giving me all the advice on how to fish this lake. Yeah, it's looking good for a few more bites. I have just spotted one down there. I'm gonna use my new best friend, a bushwhacker baiting pole, get a rig down there, and get another carp, I hope.
Mike's gagging to get in front of the camera. I know he's a cameraman and that, but I tell ya, he's gagging. Look at him. Like, did you see him in that? I swear he wasn't even shouting Finn. 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 You're in. Finn. He just wants to be famous, that Mike.
Change of events, Mike. It's all right. You keep hold of it. He's had a few.
Amateur hour. I'm embarrassed, frankly. Embarrassed.
What's he like for you? I thought you were winding me up, and then I was like looking, and I seen the fish. There we have it, fish number three. Mikey turned up just in time to witness me nearly breaking my arm getting this one. Yeah, probably the smallest carp in the lake, but it shows the future is bright. Get a cut back and try and get a bigger one. Well, I've just popped round into this little corner. There's a few fish knocking about, and to be honest, after catching that small one over there, it went a little bit lifeless. So I've came around here, just used the bushwhacker, put the rig probably where no one else or very few people have ever fished. But I do think there is a chance of catching a carp. If not, I'm definitely gonna hook a swan in the next 20 minutes because they won't leave me alone. Let's hope the carp love the scorpion squid flake as much as these swans. Cocked it up on the other side, swans came in. Yeah, spooked off the carp because they're idiots. So I've came back around here. But I have a couple of fish down this margin where I'm gonna be cutting one rod. Not sure what I'm doing with the second. Yeah, caught one today, went big, broke my wrist, hurt, lost one. Not a bad day. What about you, Mike? What are you saying?
Until there's a pizza in my stomach, mate.
Until there's a pizza.
Yeah, we're gonna get some food ordered, kick back, and wait
not
for
having
Finn.
A Chinese. Mikey's put his foot down, yeah. We're not having a Chinese.
Anything but a Chinese.
Anything but a Chinese. Need a bit of what is it? Curry sauce, gravy sauce on your pizza.
Gravy sauce. Gravy sauce.
So curry sauce. Hey,
gotta have gravy on pizza, mate.
All jokes aside, Finn is an absolute demon. He catches them wherever we take him, and then that was just a bit of behind the scenes in terms of what goes into one of those little shoots. You know, they're not these grand productions that we do. It is usually a cameraman or two cameramen and Finn. They go in, they turn it around quickly, and he's making a really, really cool little series. So if you do get a chance to watch any of them, check them out. Let us know what you think. There'll be plenty more of them in the future.
Know what I've seen?
Yeah.
What, all together?
Yeah.
Everything.
What's all the point in about 5-10 minutes ago?
No, to be fair, these boys reckon they've seen one.
Not buying it.
It helps you actually look through the water.
Well, trying to do stuff at the same time. It's gone from being very quiet here to very busy. Three other anglers have turned up. That's not ideal, but the positive way of looking at it is they're all going to start getting their bait boats out and smashing leads about, which, if the fish are not in my area, might draw them to my area. That's about as positive I can be at the moment. Plenty of time. How long do you reckon, boys? 20 hours? 21? How long does it take to catch a carp? 2 minutes.
Look, I've got this.
Yeah, bring it up a bit closer to me there.
Whoa!
Pick that one up.
Yeah, go on up.
Go on, son.
Yeah, there's a bite coming there, too. Yeah.
Caught one yet, Tom?
No.
Nothing.
Nothing!
Being the true professionals that we are, we thought we'd buy the time by shooting a little piece, eh?
What? This is for me, this is my Instagram.
No, they'll recognise my manly hands. Yeah, that's not done.
Look at my little puppy.
It's on my man.
Man? You look like a pregnant woman.
Look like your mum after she's been down a pub on a Friday night.
Thank you. Is that happening? Did it get swelled up?
The f***ing rate she got there.
I was going to say, we work for a massive carp fishing manufacturer which does all sorts of luggage to carry everything you need, and you've decided to transport some of your stuff in what?
No, we needed the black bag anyway for the rubbish.
Hold up your bin bag. Hold up your luggage.
Hey.
Chocolate fingers. Cappy's fingers.
What is that? That's your packed lunch box, is it? Is that everything you got?
Yeah.
Just like...
Well, that's it, Tom.
The rest of it.
Where's your food?
That's in there, that's his kettle, stove, food and bits.
And chocolate fingers in there.
Chocolate. But like, where's the rest of your stuff?
What's that?
I've heard of travelling light, but like...
What else do I need?
Like, where's your bait? Like, your pop-ups and that?
In my barrel pockets.
Everything's just in
I'm only single hook bait fisher, I don't need bait.
Yeah, I know, but like, I'm just trying to think what's in my rucksack and why I haven't got a rucksack yet. Why you haven't got anything?
You take too much.
quite literally lure fishing, isn't it?
I bet he followed it, didn't I?
Life at Nash.
Get on the zigs, mate.
Absolutely done me, isn't he? Just on dark. Five and a bit, isn't it?
How do you know that's five and a bit? You're standing on the slope. How do you know it's five and a bit? Up to your eye level.
It's around that, isn't it? If I'm 6'2 or whatever, 6'1, 6'2.
6'4, something like that.
Grasshopper walks into a bar,
yeah,
and the barman says, "Oh my God, we've got a drink named after you." And he goes, "You've got a drink called Steve."
Oh, we're awake.
Still can't. Look. It's meant to be spring. Sorry to drag you out, Mikey. I know you've been living the high life, haven't you?
No, it's been not been too bad.
Your life at Nash Shoots. This is the doldrums for you, isn't it?
Yeah, back in England.
Back in England. Last time I saw you and doing a bit of life at Nash footage, you and Tame were in Thailand.
Yeah, a little bit warmer than this.
And you got a chance to do a bit of fishing, didn't you?
We certainly did.
Was it better than here?
Yeah, just a tad.
Sure?
Just a tad. Unless we catch a 50 pounder.
It's like a hook a duck over there.
Sorry, what, hook a duck?
Hook a duck.
Hook a duck.
Easy, man.
You tell Alan that.
I will.
Well, that didn't last very long. I didn't even make it to the hotel. I had a little look in the creek, see a couple. Grabbed my little sort of very light lure rod. It's actually a scope, bizarrely enough. Three piece, half pound test curve, thin braid, a little bit of fluorocarbon, and yeah, a little jig head. Watch this.
I told them this morning, put some music on, get action.
And the fish will come.
Harry White first. What was his name?
Tambaki.
Yeah, Tambaki. Yeah. Ugly f***er. Can have you put Neil Diamond on?
It rips off.
Do you know what happened when you put Damas on?
Damas and Shanamas.
We do it later. Okie dokie. Let them spray first. That's what I do. They trick the hook halt. Well, Tim is playing.
Do you need that one?
Another one.
Go on, Timmy boy.
I'm not playing the fish. The fish is playing me.
Okay. Yep, yes, I like a knocker.
I'm a knocker.
Bye bye.
Well done, mate.
Jurassic Park, mate. Mental.
Have a fire one. Yeah, take it.
Oh, no,
go on, have a You ain't got to claim it, but have a go.
No, it's all right, I'll wait.
We're waiting.
I'm waiting.
So me and Tone get a little break today. We're going to have a fish.
Yeah, we're going to tell Alan to stay out as long as possible. Treat yourself, have a family day.
Yeah, that's a pot round to see the boys. Go and have a bit of breakfast.
Well, you're most welcome. If this rod goes, that's yours, okay? I'm going to run to it anyway. Get straight for it. When you hook a big one, it's just like a submarine going up a lake.
Yeah.
Hey.
He doesn't even know. So it ends. You won't mind a mirror like that though, would you?
Right, first time. This is to decide who gets to use the mighty bolt machine. Oh, we've figured out how to use yet until we find a gilly.
Do rock, paper, scissors, go.
Yeah, ready? Rock, paper, scissors, go.
Ooh!
Ooh, there we go. Someone's going first.
All right.
Right, this is not going to be a first time cast.
Well done.
At all.
So we've been told palm trees are the one.
That way, anyway.
Yeah, out there somewhere. Not too much. Perfect.
I'm gonna leave it.
Yeah.
That sounded positive.
The Dutch say perfect. They've been spanking them up this week.
Oh, I thought it's come back up. No.
It's all right. It's all right.
Nah, I should have hit that. I saw it taking line. Yeah, big bit of fizzing up there as well.
Oh, there he is, man.
There he is, Todd. Come on. Yeah, boy.
Hey. He'll do.
Oh, no, no picture.
It's all right. We'll catch some more.
We'll get another one.
Another one on the carp rod.
It's a good day. Getting it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good work.
Excellent, mate.
Yeah.
Look at that go.
Yeah, sweet, mate.
Ooh.
Well done.
Ooh. Time for lunch.
Thailand was good then, yeah?
Very nice.
Did you do it?
Nah.
Do you know what I mean?
Nah.
Thailand?
Nah. Not for me, mate.
You sure? What? I meant catch a Siamese carp.
You caught many a carp.
Yeah, that's what I was on about.
Nah, you didn't, you mean?
A man. Since you left us, it's been slow for Tom. And we've moved swims, new swim. Caught a tench.
On a zig, pike on a zig.
Pike on a zig, tench on a zig.
Just need a carp. But I'm on them now, aren't I? It's taking me 21 hours to get on the fish. But
yeah, on them. Definitely going to happen. We watched a bit of the old Life at Nash things, didn't we? Eh?
Yeah.
That was fun, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, realised how everything's gone.
Can it now. No offence, Mikey.
Not taken,
not
boys.
Just Life at Nash, most Nash productions.
Is it?
Well, yeah.
Because this is a bit of a behind the scenes one about yours truly, Tom's going to interview me. And yeah?
Do I have to do this?
The people want to know what my job involves and how they go and do it.
Yeah, but I'm just about to ruin a whole fishing trip by not catching one. You want to do this?
What do you want to know?
First question, how the hell did you blag yourself a job at Nash?
How did I get my job at Nash?
Oh yeah, blag yourself.
Blag?
Yeah.
What were you doing? There was actually a bit of a blag in it. Loz got me the job basically. Loz, my old mate Loz worked here. Remember him?
He's not dead. just don't see him as much.
And I did some awful little videos with him and they were desperate for a new videographer. So Blair called me one day and just offered me a job out of the blue for, you know, pittance. Minimum wage, less than, mainly just boilies, and I took it, and here I am now. But it was a bit of a blag because on my first day, he said to me, one of my first jobs was to go across Europe and film all these European DVDs, and he said to me, yeah, you'll be sweet at that though, because you know like four languages, don't you? And I was like, no, I barely know English.
Only knew Svenba.
all I knew was Fenland boy. Yeah, someone had told him I spoke like four languages and maybe that helped in securing the job, but still here, so it must have worked. That's how I blagged myself a job here.
This is a pub question, this one. What advice would you give to someone young wanting to get into the industry?
Do they have to be young or anyone trying to get in the industry?
Anyone, I guess, but more so young people who are maybe leaving school and looking to further develop their education.
I think the biggest advice, the question I get that asked the most is how do I get into it? But a lot of people, they're anglers first and they want to be in the industry because they love fishing, which is great. They don't have any interest in video production, but they just want it as an in because they want to, I don't know, work with Blair and get free bait and that sort of thing. So my biggest advice is to be as passionate about your career as you are about carp fishing. Go out there, learn yourself a skill set, and then be able to apply it to fishing as well. Good that, wasn't it?
Yeah. I'll be honest, I wasn't listening.
I was going to say, you turned off.
I'm looking for fish, mate. I'm still trying to capture it. It sounded good though. Is there anything that you know now that you wish you learned when you was younger?
There's a song, that's a song, isn't it?
Oh, I've got a better one. Oh no, go on, answer that one first. Be quick. Don't go on with this one.
Do what makes you happy. Short and sweet. Do what makes you happy. Be bloody good at it.
Yeah. Most impressive bit of angling you've seen, or you've filmed from one of our boys. Could be a social film,
it's a leading question. What do you want me to say? What are you after? What do you think, Phil? Carp in the cup box.
Maybe. You weren't there though.
I weren't there.
Yeah, but Tone and Thingy West, and I just think it didn't get the credit it deserved.
It did so.
Put a little clip of it on this, the ending bit, the emotional music, me holding up the scaly. Beautiful.
Do you know, have you watched it? You haven't watched it, have you? No.
Seen clips.
Seen clips. Ian watched it. No one watched it.
Check this out.
I'm lost for words, to be honest. I don't know what to say.
Best session of his life.
Just good angling it was, good solid angling. People don't know what they
don't know what they miss. Missing out on.
They don't know they're
bored
these days.
It's like 30,000 views in like 2 years or something.
Yeah, but proper angling. But no, they like Alan Blair at a park lake with a bit of bread and a fucking £6 off.
Well, it's only a little babby, but it was a lot of fun catching it. Swat.
Whatever.
It'd have to be
Alan Blair.
At Social 2. He did well, didn't he? Austria. He really built into that session and then like proper made it happen at the end. Struggled, he lost one. Everyone else around him was catching, but he was on like the tough lake and he was literally catching them out on this big lake, dropping his rig and he was literally just taking a pinch and just flicking it down. It was just dropping into like 25 metres of water. Basically nothing.
Underwater cameras, everything, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
Good angling.
Then once he got it cracked, it was just bang, 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 and it just ended it up in like a 68 pounder. So
Wilson done one that week.
Oh,
Wilson.
Nah, can't remember. Kid who used to cry.
He
cried a lot. Didn't
massive forehead. Well, that was me actually, wasn't it?
Yeah, don't talk to me about massive foreheads.
Then again,
that's the end of the question.
That's
then.
That's all I got, I think.
Don't worry about it. Hope you guys learned something.
Carping in the Cotswolds.
So for the final section of this episode of Life at Nash, we're going to take you back to just a few weeks ago. In fact, our French team hosted a really, really cool event across a weekend, which was like a Nash Open Day. It's something that I think personally was a really, really good idea, and maybe it's something we'll look at doing in the UK in the future. A few of the guys, Alfie, Henry being a couple of them, they went out there, they went to help host the event and help set up for what turned out to be a really strenuous and stressful time for all of them.
Oh, I woke up this morning with my head in the foot section of my sleep system.
I didn't know it was zipped up.
And I 100% went to bed the correct way.
Well, kinda. Anyway, over to Alfie and Henry, who hosted the event.
Okay, welcome to France. You join us at what is a new event in the Nash National Day. It's organised by Jocelyn and the rest of the French team, and it's basically like a festival of carp fishing.
There's a lot going on, loads of the teams are here. It's really nice to have everyone in one place together, and then later on, I think Alan and Ollie are going to be up on the deck, a bit of a party, which is a bit different. You know, a few beers up there, that's really great. But for now, we're just going to have a wander around and see what's happening.
I just broke in there.
What did you do? Just go, meet a Henry smash.
Are they all right? Have they started drinking or something? What was wrong with her? Anywho, the event itself, great, great success. They had a casting section.
I'm having a go. I'm a bit nervous, there's a lot of people there.
Proud. But
whatever happens, I won't know what they're saying.
They had a bivvy village, they had a tackle shop open, they had all the superstars head over, food vans.
Heineken.
Heineken.
Yeah.
It's a Heineken.
Cheers.
Fucking hell.
Big party. It looked really, really cool, and I'm actually a little bit jealous that I didn't go over myself. Henry, however, never one to really miss an opportunity. He took this chance to head out a couple of days before the event and stay a few days after the event to go fishing in France. What happened was nothing short of ridiculous for him and well worth the extra few days off. Luckily for us, he did take his camera out there and he did do a little bit of filming. So we're gonna leave you on a little section of what Henry got up to. Check this out.
Hi everyone, you join me back in France after a very successful start on the canal, followed by a not so successful trip in terms of fishing at the Nash National Day, but in terms of drinking beer with European teams, we were very successful in that. But now back to fishing. I've got 4 days before I need to go on a quite a big shoot, so it made no sense to go back to England because we're going to do the shoot in France. I'm staying here 4 days, I'm going to work from the bank and fish what looks like pretty nice lake. The only thing I've got to do now is do a couple of laps, unload the van, sort of figure out where I'm fishing. Never fished it before. Samir gave me a few pins at the show, said check these places out. Gone and looked at a few lakes and this is the one I like the most. So I'm gonna fish here, don't really know what's in here. Samir's not fished it for a good few years either, so bit of a mystery. It's all part of the fun. So finish the lap and get cracking. Okay, we're in the swim now. Absolute carnage, crap everywhere, but bit of a race against time to get everything out. So I think the plan is I'm gonna crack on, get the rods out. It's all gonna be in the dark, so there's no point filming it, but I'll see you guys in the morning, hopefully with a fish. But yeah, I'm not so sure what the rules are here, so I could also be paid a visit by the guard de pêche at some point, which may throw a spanner in the works, but that's all part of this public lake fishing. You never really know what the rules are. So I'm gonna crack on, see you guys in the morning, hopefully with a fish. If not, for a little update, I'll show you exactly where I'm fishing. Loudly so you can hear me on the mic, but after what was a calamitous night since I last saw you, I'm gonna catch up with you all in a minute about what happened. But I had a little plan. Dewey said it would come together, got the rods out this morning. I'll explain all that later. 2 hours later, double take. The first 45-pound mirror, beautiful fish, absolutely blown away with it. What more could you want? An even bigger one. An even bigger common in the net as well. I'm gonna get him out now and show you. But what a star, I love it. Public lake fishing in France, in spring. It doesn't get any better. Mega, thank you, carp. Wow. Thought it was a bit bigger, not that much bigger. 61 pounds, public lake common. Ah, ooh la la. There we go. What do you say to that? New PB, common, new French PB. Over 100 pounds of carp in 10 minutes. Look at it, man. Wicked. Well, about 12 hours ago, I was feeling very, very different. So last time I spoke to you, besides those fish just then, which I can't quite believe I've just caught. Last time I spoke to you, I was just come across a lake on the boat, ready to set up. Like I said, I didn't really know what the rules were. And a lot of the time with this French public fishing, you kind of just got to go for it and someone will hopefully tell you what the rules are, because they don't have rules pinned up anywhere. I thought, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sleep here tonight 100% and fish tomorrow and maybe the day after, because I'm pretty shattered. I need to get some work and I'm actually supposed to be working now, so probably got my laptop in a minute. There was a lot of fish activity, a lot of them were boshing, so I felt quite confident. Anyway, I must have drifted off again, and then I got woken about 8:30 to an absolute screamer. 45-pound mirror. I can't believe it. I thought that the tactic might work, but not this quickly. So very happy with that. Just as I net it, my other rod goes. Maybe like a minute after I've netted it, the rod goes. Playing it, this one feels better, feels much better in the net. Looks a lot bigger, 61 pound, and that's what you've just seen there. So the plan is coming together, and I don't think I'm gonna be moving down to that gravel pit connected to the river if the stock is what it looks like it could be in here. Don't need to now. I'm gonna stay put, days only. Come on.
Oh, look at that carp. And that is almost in there now. Whoa! Come on, the boys. See a dream. What the f***? That's huge.
I can't quite believe what I'm about to say, but this fish is even bigger than yesterday's. Let me get him up for you and show you. 64. Seems crazy even saying it. 64 pounds. Ridiculous, powerful common carp. Exactly the same time as yesterday. I was just laying in bed, actually fell in the edge. So I'd taken my ZT joggers off, just getting warm under the bed, thinking I had a bite about this time yesterday. And it's ripped off, and I had an absolute beasting of a fight. And look what we have caught. Oh my God, this session is unbelievable. Don't be put off by days only venues. Don't be put off by public water fishing, because look what you can catch. Oh my God, special fish.
Well, there we go. That's the end of another episode of Life at Nash. Unfortunately, Tommy did not catch on for the cameras, but that's fishing. We may put it out later this year. We may put it out next year. I hope it gave you a good insight into what we do as a media team. I hope you've enjoyed this episode, and we will see you next time.